have recently characterized the dynamics of soluble proteins in great detail, and we are at the moment exploring the functional importance of those, but also the kinetics which is involved in the dynamics, and we have introduced some new techniques in order to measure those dynamics also at faster timescales than that was previously possible. So that is one of the most recent achievements where we have gone. Another one is on more applied field in neurodegeneration, where we are trying to characterize the influence of intellectually disordered proteins that aggregate and that lead to diseases like Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, diabetes 2, but also Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. We are working on many systems. For example, I mentioned this signal transduction and so on, which is working on bacteria. And there, I mean, our work is more on the basic mechanisms, and one doesn't really know where it leads to. And I should also mention that, of course, since I'm working with Max Planck, and Max Planck once said that basic understanding has to precede application. So biomedical applications is also something that is coming behind. Nevertheless, I should mention that maybe the most advanced project that we are doing at the moment is on neurodegeneration, where in a joint effort, not only by NMR spectroscopy, we have characterized structural transitions between monomeric, oligomeric, and fibrillar states. We have also been able to actually influence and divert aggregation pathways with a small molecule. I mean, this may lead at some point in time to testing on humans.